Okay, this is the second part on cellular organelles. So we're talking about microtubules, which become the pathways, which are the pathways or the roads along which transport vesicles travel, going from one organelle to another, or exiting the cell, or entering the cell, and so on. Some of them actually are packaged, some of the transport vesicles actually are packaged and become organelles. In any case, where does the transportation occur? Along the microtubule. And someone in class thought it was inside the microtubule, but it's not. Let's look at how it travels along the microtubule. This was just a review that we did at the beginning, a warm-up. Okay, so this is supposed to be the Golgi bodies. Here I wrote, a protein synthesis and packaging are complete inside the Golgi body. So now a vesicle buds off. Here it is budding off. They changed its color, so it now becomes noticeable. Buds off the Golgi apparatus, and here is the microtubule, so it's going to travel along it. And this is where it starts to look like sci-fi. It gets this little motor protein. Here it's represented in green, and again here. And it does something which very much resembles walking along the microtubule till it gets to its destination, wherever it needs to go in the cell. This one needed to be secreted, this one needed to be anchored to the cell membrane, and so on. Different things have different destinations, but the pathway is along the microtubule, and it has this strange way of walking. So here's a closer look. This looks comical to you, perhaps, and it actually should because it's really crazy looking. The real thing is really odd. These motor proteins are the proteins which have a way of attaching to the surface of the microtubule, and it literally looks like a funny sort of walking. You can see it in the video. I think most of you remember it from class. This is a close-up of the motor proteins. The green tube is the microtubule. These are the motor proteins, and there would be some transport vesicle attached to it, right? Notice the transport vesicle has weird proteins and things in it because it also needs labels to figure out what its destination is and what its contents are and where it should be going and so on. Okay, if you want examples of what kinds of transport would be occurring in the cell, there's a couple examples I wrote out here. If you want to understand this diagram, in a way it's not that different from the others. These are the motor proteins, and you notice that they're carrying various packages and they're even carrying organelles, right? So it's kind of a schematic diagram, but it might be interesting. This was our warm-up. Hopefully you have notes from this warm-up. This was kind of a useful way of reviewing organelles. Again, to show that even an entire organelle can be transported along a microtubule with various motor proteins. We also watched a real short video in kinesin that I have linked in a couple slides. Okay, another overview of the big picture in the cell of the various pathways for the various interactions. Same thing here. I wanted to just look quickly at the dynamic instability of microtubules. So microtubules have this funny characteristic. They're being made and they're being assembled and disassembled constantly. Apparently every few minutes they alternate between growing and shrinking. It's really kind of mysterious and crazy to watch. In that video, in that really cool animation from Harvard University, they did a really good job of showing that. And it's wild to watch it happening. So anyway, maybe there was something else I was gonna say. I can't remember, so let's move on. Here is one last organelle we haven't talked about. You probably recognize it from biology. Individually, these are centrioles together at right angles. These two little pieces are called a centrosome. You can learn either name. They're fine, just be able to recognize them. If you notice, what do they look like? Two little pieces of microtubule. In fact, that's what they are. And their function is they're the place from which microtubules are built and organized, as in what route they need to take and where they need to go. The most vivid example of this is during mitosis, and the chromosomes are separated, traveling along these microtubule fibers. And where are the microtubules made from? From the centrosome present at each end of the spindle. This is actually the scientific name for it. I think it's kind of comical. MTOC, Major Microtubule Organizing Center. So these are present not only in at the end of each spindles, but for example, at the base of flagella and cilia, which are full of microtubules and so on. Okay, oh, this was stuff you don't need to know for the test. It was to better understand that super cool video, Inner Life of Cells. This is also to understand inner life of cells. Okay, simple, straightforward overview. If you like to study from videos, that one can be good. This one's worth watching. Endomembrane functions, which are important. This one was the one on kinesin to better understand the importance of transportation within the cell and the motor vehicles moving the transport vesicles. This is the one you don't need to know for the test, but it was super duper cool that we watched in class. And this is cutesy biology. Make sure this should be really easy for you. I think it all is pretty straightforward. Let me see if anything is not straightforward. The main thing implied here is transport vesicles and microtubules, right? The main thing implied here is not exactly an organelle, but it would be the cell membrane. I think everything else is quite straightforward. Lots involved here because smooth ER for lipid synthesis, rough ER, Golgi bodies, transport vesicles for protein synthesis. Okay, I think that's everything. Take care, girls.